In this video, let us see phasor diagrams, which are actually very crucial and very important. Okay, actually, like you know, as I said in my previous session also, some of the faculties may consider VN inverted V curves to explain them. Okay, which should not be done for GATE. Okay, because GATE in the sense problems can be easily solved with phasor diagram concept only. For example, we know that what is active power? P equal to EF VT by XS sine delta. Okay, and what about the Q output? Q output is going to be like you know VT by XS into EF cos delta minus VT. Okay, so we have these two equations already we derived in our previous session. Now let us draw one phasor diagram. One thing is we should not get confused. Like you know, whatever phasor diagram we have drawn in the transformer, same thing we are going to do, except like you know, resistance will not be considered. For example, if this is VT, if this is EF at an angle plus delta, okay, and VT at an angle zero, and this is IA at an angle pi, and this is XS. In transformer, how we have drawn phasor diagram? VT plus IA XS is going to be F. Okay, so for example, if I think of VT like this. Okay, now for example, if IA is lagging. Okay, so if IA is lagging, in the sense IA will be like this. Okay, now means for example, if I consider IA RA, IA XS, how it look like? VT plus IA RA, IA IA RA inline, and plus IA XS, IA IA XS 90 degrees lead with respect to current. Okay, now anyway, resistance is not considered, so VT plus IA 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 XS. Okay, so IA XS will be 90 degrees to here. So VT plus IA XS should be 90 degrees to IA, IA XS. Okay, so length should be more here, IA XS, compared to like you know, armature resistance. Already we have seen X by R ratio of transfer, sorry, alternator is very high. So if it is like this, this is going to be EF. Okay, now the angle between VT and EF is delta, and the angle between VT and IA is pi. Same phasor diagram we are going to draw. Okay, but I'm going to take VT at like this, okay, vertical line, and IA lagging or leading. Okay, for example, my alternator is connected with infinite bus. Okay, so the moment alternator is connected with infinite bus, so this is connected with infinite bus. What is infinite bus? Infinite bus in the sense, let me tell you one thing. Okay, let us see how alternator, when it is isolated, how it behave. When it is connected with infinite bus, how it behave. Okay, so basically here, if you think like you know, alternator isolated, how we discussed in transformer secondary, everything is going to be same, because transformer secondary is nothing but generator only. Okay, for example, this is alternator and this is load connected isolated. Okay, so it is not connected to what they say infinite bus. Now for example, this is alternator and this is load. For example, if load is not there, alternator has to operate at no load. For example, if lagging power factor, this is lagging power factor, inductive dominated load is connected to here, automatically my alternator has to operate at lagging. Now for example, alternator and this load is connected with capacitive dominated, under that condition my alternator is forced to operate at leading. Okay, now means for example, if you think of power factor, alternator, load, depending upon the load, alternator power factor will be decided. Depending upon the load, magnitude of current will be decided. Okay, so magnitude of current will be decided by the load impedance, and power factor of the alternator will be decided by the load X by R ratio. Okay, so point here is, like you know, depending upon the load, everything will vary in alternator, that is isolated case. Okay, for example, this is alternator and this is load, and in between I am going to be infinite bus. How the analysis will become? Okay, so the moment, for example, I'm the infinite bus, for the infinite bus load is connected to the infinite bus generator is connected. For example, generator is operating at 0.9 power factor lag, and load is also 0.9 power factor lag. Okay, now coincidentally, now for example, if load shut down, do I have to change this alternator anything? No, because alternator is going to supply some P power to infinite bus. Infinite bus will deliver that particular P power anywhere all over India. Okay, so like, you know, for example, load and this particular alternator, if load power factor is varied, lagging to leading, it need not vary power factor because it is connected with the infinite bus. What is the definition of infinite bus? In the sense, whatever the power you want to sell to the infinite bus, sell it, take the money. Okay, whatever the power you want to take from infinite bus, take that and pay the money, that's it. Okay, so we should not see, like, you know, alternator is supplying some power to infinite bus. Where that power is going, it's none of your business. Okay, for example, now, for example, like, you know, alternator load directly connected. Okay, infinite bus is not there. So under that condition, what will happen means my alternator power factor will be decided by the load. For example, in between these two, if I am there, infinite bus. Okay, so my power factor will be decided by this operating engineer. Okay, so my alternator, once it is connected with the infinite bus, can you vary the terminal voltage? No. Okay, so for example, alternator, if it is operating at lagging, once it is connected with the infinite bus, forget about the load, we need not bother about the load. For example, alternator is supplying react power. Where it is going, it's none of our business. If alternator is supplying some active power P to the infinite bus, where that particular power is being, like, you know, shared, it doesn't matter. Okay, we should not bother. So alternator power factor will be decided by the operating engineer once it is connected with the infinite bus. And alternator, like, you know, loading, always alternator will be operated at full load only, because I told you previously, once it is connected with the infinite bus, that infinite bus will be all over India. Getting my point, right? So it's going to be national grid. Once alternator is connected with infinite bus, whatever the power you want to sell, you can sell. Whatever the reactive power you want to give, you can give. Okay, of course, Q minimum, Q maximum will be there. We will see that in load flow studies. Okay, so anyway, point here is very simple. Once alternator is connected with infinite bus, terminal voltage cannot be changed. Okay, now normally, like, you know, in GATE, of course, so 2-3 theoretical questions they asked, but normally in GATE, connected with infinite bus only they will ask. Okay, so for example, if I try to draw the same phasor in this direction, VT. Okay, now with respect to VT, for example, IA is lagging. Okay, so VT at an angle 0. Okay, R1 at an angle 0 in per unit quantities. For example, this is IA, 90 degrees to IA. 90 degrees to IA, IA axis will be there. Okay, so this is going to be IA axis, and this is going to be EF. Don't get scared, like, you know, whatever the phasor diagram we have drawn in transformers, same phasor diagram we are going to draw. Okay, so VT, one at an angle 0, infinite bus, it cannot be shared. Okay, IA is lagging behind, so IA is lagging behind in this VT plus IA axis, 90 degrees to here, IA axis is going to be EF. The angle between VT and IA is pi, power factor angle. The angle between VT and EF is going to be delta, power angle or torque angle. Now let us try to understand this phasor diagram properly. See here, P equal to EF VT by XS sine delta once it is connected with infinite bus. Okay, so once it is connected with infinite bus, VT is going to be constant, and if you think of XS, synchronous reactance, it's going to be machine constant. Okay, so the moment it is machine constant, this will vanish. So directly I can say P is directly proportional to EF sine delta. Okay, where is EF sine delta? For example, EF delta, sine delta opposite, so EF sine delta is going to be this. Okay, so depending upon EF delta, sine delta, depending upon the EF sine delta, active power will be there. Okay, now let us think of Q, reactive power. Okay, now I will introduce you, like, you know, what is meant by over excited, what is meant by under excited and all. Okay, VT is going to be constant, XS is going to be constant, machine constant, and VT is going to be constant. Now my reactive power directly depends upon EF cos delta minus VT. Okay, so what is, where is EF cos delta? For example, EF delta. So EF cos delta is this. Okay, so this is going to be EF cos delta. Okay, EF cos delta is going to be this. Okay, now EF cos delta minus VT. So EF cos delta, VT is here, minus VT. So this will be deciding factor for Q reactive power. Okay, so EF sin delta will give you always active power. EF cos delta minus VT is going to give you reactive power. Okay, now let us see, means long back, like, you know, in our first videos of synchronous, we discussed that overexcited synchronous machine supply reactive power. Okay, for example, I'm generator, when I'm going to supply reactive power, means my load should absorb. When load will absorb, that particular load should have inductive dominated. So when that is inductive and when load is forced to be operated at lagging conditions, alternator is supposed to be operated at lagging conditions. So alternator operating at lagging, load is inductive. Inductive will absorb, so my alternator should supply. Okay, whenever alternator is supplying reactive power, means that it is overexcited. Okay, now is this particular alternator supplying or absorbing reactive power? Supplying. Why? EF cos delta minus VT is positive. Okay, so EF cos delta minus VT is going to be positive. So this is going to be Q output. Okay, so it is supplying reactive power. Okay, for example, we can say this as a overexcited. Okay, now it is supplying reactive power. For example, if an alternator is operating at, like, you know, unity power factor. Okay, now anyway, VT cannot be changed. Infinite bus, VT at an angle zero. Okay, now my particular operating engineer managed the field current in such a way that, like, you know, means now my alternator is operating at unity power factor. For example, it is operating at unity power factor. Okay, so VT, IA, now IA, IA axis 90 degrees. Now VT plus IA axis, this is going to be IA axis is going to be EF. And this is going to be delta. Now what is active power and reactive power? EF delta sin delta is going to be active power. Okay, and what is reactive power? EF cos delta minus VT is going to be zero. Okay, so the moment, like, you know, alternator is not supplying reactive power, means that it is normal excitation. Okay, so this is called previously overexcited, now it is normal excitation. Now let us think of under excitation in the sense, for example, this is VT and this is IA. With respect to VT, IA is leading or not? Yes. So with respect to VT, IA is leading, means that alternator, for example, I'm the alternator operating at leading means that virtually load should have capacitive nature. So capacitance supply reactive power, so alternator has to absorb reactive power. Let us see that, like, you know, if IA is here, okay, VT, IA, IA axis. Okay, so for example, if I think of 90 degrees to here, okay, so means, like, you know, VT, IA, IA axis, so VT plus IA axis, this is going to be IA axis is going to be EF. Okay, now what is active power and reactive power? If you see, this is delta. Okay, and here EF sin delta is going to be active power related one. Okay, what is reactive power? Reactive power is going to be EF delta, EF cos delta. This is going to be EF cos delta. Now EF cos delta, this much length minus more length VT. Okay, so EF cos delta minus VT more is going to give you negative, means that in our equation, means Q output is going to be negative, in the sense it is supplying negative reactive power, means that it is absorbing positive reactive power. Okay, so point here is, like, you know, the moment if it is this scenario, it is called as underexcited. Okay, so in underexcited, okay, in underexcited synchronous machine, like, you know, we started at starting. Okay, underexcited synchronous machine absorb reactive power. Yes, it is absorbing. And normal excitation, it will neither deliver nor absorb. And over excitation, it will supply reactive power. Okay, so means all together, what are the fundamental things we learned? Okay, EF sine delta will be giving the information related to active power. EF cos delta minus VT will give you information about the reactive power. Now, if you know this, like, you know, we need not bother about V curves, inverted V curves, so much of theory kind of stuff. Okay, now at last one conclusion I have to give you here. What is that conclusion? If you observe, always EF is leading VT. Okay, so in our this thing also, okay, EF is leading VT. This is VT. Okay, and here also EF is leading VT. Okay, means let me tell you one thing, EF should lead VT in alternator, because we discussed previously if this is resultant S pole. Okay, and this is field pole. This is resultant S pole, this field pole N pole. So both are rotating like this. No torque. For example, when it will absorb mechanical power, this particular pole should be ahead. Okay, then what will happen? This particular pole will try to go back. Back torque is there, but your prime mover is not allowing to go back. Your prime mover is not allowing it to go back. Means the torque is in this direction, your prime mover is not allowing. So my prime mover has to deliver mechanical energy to this. And this mechanical energy will be converted into electrical energy. Okay, so if this is field pole, if both are rotating like this, this is resultant, this is field pole, both are rotating like this. Now, compulsorily, field pole should be ahead of resultant alternator. Okay, for example, this is like this. If both are rotating like this, no torque. For example, if it has fallen back, then what will happen? Means this is S pole, this is N pole, means attraction will be in this direction. Torque direction will be in this direction, and both are rotating in the same direction. So torque development and direction of rotation will be in the same direction motor. Okay, simple logic. If field pole ahead, resultant generator. This is field pole. Field pole lagging behind resultant, it's going to be motor. Okay, here also the same situation here. For example, field pole, field MMF will give you EF. So EF should lead VT. Generator. EF should lag VT, motor. Field pole should lead resultant, generator. Field pole should lag behind resultant, motor.